And that'll do it for Mount Pleasant, Michigan. The Thundering Herd gets everything the Chippewas have and then a little bit extra.
Instead of saying Marshall dodged a bullet here this afternoon, I'm going to say to you, they've dodged a mortar shell.
Although the Herd came out on top, their poor performance was not going to be overlooked by their field general.
Offense, you look like some too many damn mistakes. Can we go back Monday with a smile on our face, jumping around? We almost lost. Pick this up, man. It's bull. I know it. Since you mentioned 5 points, we playing them to the last five.
So you playing on defense?
It's bull. I'm tired of that. Get our head out of our ass, man.
I mean, he was just being a leader. I mean, he was just saying what needed to be said. You know, we said that people have, I mean, we always got excuses. When something happens, we always got excuses. But some good ball clubs don't have excuses. They find a way to fix it. So, I mean, he was just doing what he's supposed to do. Just being a leader and stepping up. I mean, it had to be said. Back to the drawing board, baby.
After struggling at Central Michigan, the Herd again went on the road the following week to face lowly Akron.
The Zips are 1-7 on the year and looking for their first Mid-American Conference win. In fact, they're looking for their first win over a 1A opponent altogether. Their only victory is over Liberty.
Let's go, Herd! Let's go, Herd! Let's go, Herd!
Have some fun here now. Hey, protect the football and create turnovers. Protect the football. Create turnovers and score in the red zone.
All day, fellas, all day. Let's see how good we can be. Let's see how good we can be.
You're the winningest football program in America. You understand? You wear this jersey with pride, you play your ass off. You understand? Play your ass off. A lot of people like to be where you are.
Hey, guys, there's only 4 games left. We got guaranteed. Well, if you get hurt, you ain't got nothing left. Play this at last game, but this is your last game you're ever gonna play.
Who are you? We are there. Back in the prayer. That will be done. On earth, blessed is the heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us our trespass. If you know what trespass against us, lead us not to take it. But live for me. Down the kingdom, power, and glory, forever and ever.
Woo! Hi, Lord! Let's get it up here. Hit the win on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Hit it! All right, the Herd against the Akron 6 in Mid-American Conference football action as they set off the fireworks here before the game.
And we're trying to dominate today, fellas! We're trying to dominate it!
With his mother cheering him on from the stands, Leftwich had the Herd threatening for an early score.
We had a great play called, and, you know, I dropped back.
We picked up the blitz, and the linebacker jumped our running back.
Every time he goes down, if he's staying down from him, like, B, get up, you know, he usually gets up. I mean, he's that tough, you know, and he was just looking down, he couldn't get up, and I knew something was wrong then.
He prides himself on getting up and walking off the field, but there's just some things you can't come back from, and it looks like he's in some real bad pain right there, Michael.
6'6", 248. We haven't seen this in 4 years. He's been so durable.
My first concern was for him. You know, and then the second concern, of course, was for the team. I mean, what's going to happen?
Byron Leftwich has to come out of the game. There's his backup, 6'3", sophomore Stan Hill.
Leftwich did come out of the game and was immediately examined by team doctors as the drive went on.
The next thing I knew, we phoned the ball, they scored a touchdown.
One Wallace back in the middle, he's not going anywhere. Football loose and picked up by Ricky McKenzie. McKenzie of Akron at midfield. See you later. Touchdown Akron.
After the Akron touchdown, Leftwich ignored the pain and returned to the game.
Well, how game and courageous is Byron Leftwich? Down 7-0, Leftwich said, I'm going back out there.
You know, the heck with the x-ray, you know, I feel as though I can go out there and still, you know, help our team win.
Leftwich provided instant offense, connecting on an 8-yard strike to Darius Watts and leading the team into the end zone.
Give the football to Wallace, make that cut off the left side, into the end zone, touchdown Marshall.
They did go right back in and lead us down for a touchdown. But you could tell something wasn't right because I mean, he couldn't even put any weight on it. He was just going back there and throwing balls on one leg.
Even after Leftwich's touchdown drive knotted the score at 7, Coach Pruitt wanted assurance that his star quarterback was healthy enough to play.
Go now, so you can get back, son.
You know, once, you know, he looked me in the eye and told me, you know, hollered at me, you know, I didn't understand, you know, he meant business. So I said, hey, let me just get this, you know, get this out the way and we see what happens.
That's the only thing about football, I tell you, it's just... You just never know.
But you know what it's told like that.
I gotta go. I think he'll be fine. If I know Byron like I do, even if it's broken, he'll still be fine, you know. But I'm still just worried about him.
You know, I was hopping into the ambulance and I asked him, you know, frankly, can you get me back before this game over? He was like, I don't know, I don't think so. Well, I got right up out that ambulance, you know, and looked at one of our guys. I was like, I need to get to a place where so I can get the x-ray and get back.
As Leftwich rushed to the hospital for x-rays, Akron continued to take advantage of the Herd's sloppy play, forcing 4 first-half turnovers and converting them into 17 points.
Touchdown, Akron! 24-10, Akron on top. Of Marshall, who's without their Heisman Trophy candidate, Byron Leftwich.
The Herd's performance without Leftwich caused emotions to stir during halftime.
Why would that be left there last night? We throw it in his face! We throw it in his freaking face! We got him hurt with a hurt leg! So what are we gonna do in the second half?
But maintain your composure and believe in yourself! Believe in yourself! Make play! Make plays and believe in yourself. Pull together. The only people we got are the people in this room. You understand? You win together, you play hard together, and you believe in each other. We can win the game if you play hard. Play to the end. You understand? Play to the end.
Let's go, baby. Who thinks that referee conflict is
now or never, bud? Let's go.
The halftime speeches failed to make a difference as Marshall continued to make critical mistakes.
Fumble the football, and Akron has got it again. A mystifying nightmare of major proportions for Marshall today. Continuing just about half this third quarter, but the reverse to Josh Davis. He dropped the football. It's loose. Do you believe it? Still loose. Marshall's going to get out.
We had just fumbled a reverse, you know, and I jumped on it, luckily, you know. It was rolling around, we lost 22 yards, and next thing I know, we look over the sideline, here comes old number 7 coming in.
Byron Leftwich is now limping his way back onto the football field, being escorted to this far end zone.
It was like a movie. I mean, we was backed up second and, I don't know what we was, second and 20, something like that, and all of a sudden I heard the crowd cheering.
The thermometer just got dialed up here at the Rubber Bowl. I don't mean temperature-wise. You're looking at the left ankle in an air cast with splints of Byron Leftwich. He is back now, the Heisman Trophy candidate.
We were down at that point. Nothing was going right. And he comes back in the game. I just said, we're going to take this game over and go down and win.
He says, get me back here in a hurry, Sheriff. He said, I can beat him on one leg.
I'm Marshall University quarterback. I feel as though I got to do whatever I can to help this team win.
Leftwich was on target right away and needed only 7 plays to get his team into the end zone.
There's the dive. Touch the plane of the goal line into the end zone. Touchdown, Marshall.
We right now, though, have a situation of which legends are made.
Marshall's emotional high was brought down to earth as Akron quickly answered.
Charlie Ford, inside the 10, inside the 10, touchdown Akron!
Down 14 with just over 12 minutes to play, Marshall still had their eyes on the comeback.
Leftwich again on second and 10, seam route, he's got Darius Watts inside the 35.
Long pass down the field, he catches it, great. I turn around, just, you know, say good job, Byron, this and that, and I see Shula grab him.
We could tell there was no way his wheel would make it down there. It was like a 40-some-yard play.
And, you know, those guys just came up to me, and, you know, just said, hold your arms up. You know, I held my arms up and they just picked me up. We wouldn't really think about the moment. You know, we wouldn't think about what really was going on. And when you sit back and look at it, you probably never seen nothing like that before. I know I haven't, but it's something that we had to do at the time. We wasn't thinking, we were just trying to win.
He's like a wounded soldier out there. I mean, it's the way we look at it. And we're gonna do everything we can to get him back down there, get him where he can stand there, take a snap, and throw the next pass.
Football world, the Herd's second loss of the year. They'll fall now in the MAC East to 4-1, and that'll elevate Miami into the lead in the MAC East.
The best players didn't win today. The best team did. This is as bad a performance since I've been here. That's the bad news. The good news is we can run the next three ball games and win the conference. Your quarterback gave you a great lesson in courage, a tremendous lesson in courage.
A reporter asked me about his Heisman chances and what was going to happen with that. And I mean, forget the Heisman. Who cares about the Heisman? That guy just proved right there what kind of player he is.
Yeah, they knew it wasn't never about no Heisman. Yeah, it wasn't never about no Heisman. It's about, you know, doing what we can do to help this team win.
I mean, he's got stats and everything, best player in the nation, I think. But just coming back in a game like that, hurt. I mean, that's just unreal what he did.
Other than my dad, I probably don't look up to anybody more than Byron Leftwich. I've never seen anything like that in my life.